This is a function generator which will generate the sinusoidal waveforms. So we have to set a function generator to 1 kilohertz. We have to press white button so that the range will be 3 kilohertz. We have to press red button so that there will be a 20 dB attenuation. So this wire represents the input from the function generator, and this is nothing but the DSO, the dual channel. So connect here wires so that one can observe the waveforms. When you press here auto, you will see that this will be the sinusoidal waveform with amplitude peak to peak 500 millivolts nearly, 520, 530 millivolts peak to peak voltage will be there. So this is nothing but the input which we have to give for the amplifier, and we have to observe that how the amplifier amplifies the input. Thank you. This is nothing but the BF245U transistor, that is nothing but the JFET. This will be nothing but gate terminal, source terminal, drain terminal. So this is our gate terminal, this is our source terminal, and this is our drain terminal. Gate, source, drain. At gate we have to make voltage divider biasing. So R1 resistance, which is nothing but 1 mega ohm resistance, then this is the R2 resistance, 220 kilo ohm resistance, and this is nothing but our coupling capacitor 1, negative entering positive, leaving negative. So this is nothing but the connection at the gate terminal. At source we have to use a resistance less than or equal to 1 kilo ohms. So this will be the resistance value, this will be the bypass capacitor we have to connect across the RS resistance. The RD resistance is nothing but 2.2 kilo ohm resistance. You have to connect to the drain terminal, and here you get the output at CC2. So this will be the connection. Now connect a 5 volt supply here. This will be the supply, which is nothing but 5 to 8 volts. I have connected now 8 volts. Nearly 8 volts supply is connected. Now input that we have checked, now we have to connect to the input of a amplifier circuit. So this is the connection where we have connected the input to the amplifier, and now we have to measure the output, observe the output. So here we'll get the output at CC2. You will observe that this will be the waveform. Now adjust the voltage knob and you will observe here amplified version of a input waveform. Here the peak to peak value is 6.48 or 45 volts, 6.64 volts. So this will be nothing but the amplified version of a input. Now we have to take the readings. For 1 kilohertz frequency, the output voltage peak to peak is nothing but 4.68. Now slowly change the frequency knob, okay, make it 2 kilohertz. So this will be the waveform. Once again you will observe that, okay, just I will shift this waveform. Observe that peak to peak voltage is same one, 4.68. Now take that reading, that is nothing but the output voltage, find out gain for that. Make frequency 3 kilohertz, once again measure peak to peak voltage, Okay, now you have to change the range, so press this white button. Okay, slowly turn on the knob, turn in such a way that the frequency becomes now 3 kilohertz. Yes, 3 kilohertz. Now make it 4 kilohertz. Once again, observe the peak to peak voltage. So like that, 3 kilohertz, 5, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Up to 10 kilohertz, you have to take the readings. So for 10 kilohertz, just measure the output voltage peak to peak, which is nothing but once again 4.68. Now, from 10 kilohertz, change it to the 20 kilohertz directly, to the 20 kilohertz. From 10 kilohertz to 20 kilohertz. Okay, observe the peak to peak voltage. So here you will have peak to peak voltage. Now from 20 kilohertz, change it to the 30 kilohertz. Observe once again here the value. Now it will reach to the maximum value. Once again press the white button so that it will change the range of frequencies. Come back to the 30 kilohertz. Yes, 30 kilohertz, take the reading. Now from 30, 40 kilohertz, 50 kilohertz, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, okay, like that you have to take the reading. So this is a reading for 100 kilohertz. You may observe that, okay, the waveform will be like this, but the voltage value we have to measure, that is nothing but 4.7, 4.6. Just move this knob. Rotate in a such a way that you may observe the waveform properly. So this setting we have to do. We don't have to press the auto button. Just we have to move this time knob so that horizontally it will just change the range of frequencies. And you will get the perfect output. You may observe the perfect output. Now from 100 kilohertz directly change to the 200 kilohertz. So this will be the 200 kilohertz frequency. For that, observe the output voltage. Once again, it is 4.72 volts. Now 300 kilohertz. So for 300 kilohertz, observe the output. Okay, once again, it is reached to the maximum value, change the range. Okay, here bring it back to the 300 kilohertz. So this is a 300 kilohertz, then 400, 500, 600, 700, okay, take it. Now, as you go on increasing the frequency, here you will observe that, okay, nearly for 500 kilohertz, the frequency, okay, at which the gain will reduce. So 500 kilohertz, that voltage value is nearly 4.1 to 4.2. So here the V peak to peak value is somewhat decreased. So once again, change it to the 800, 900, and you will observe that as for the higher frequencies, the gain get reduced. So 3.8, 3.6, 3.4, 3.2, like that. Here also one can observe the frequencies that we have applied. So like that, you have to change the frequency values and observe the gain. When we do this, okay, once again come back to the 1 kilohertz frequency, adjust the time knob so that you will get your waveform output. You will observe the same kind of a peak to peak value, 4.7 to 4.68. Now, okay, you have to reduce the frequency. So 1 kilohertz, then go for 900 hertz. Observe once again peak to peak value. 800, 500, 400, like that. Once again you have to measure the peak to peak value. This is nothing but the frequency response. For various frequencies, what will be the peak to peak value? Find out the gain and you will get the values. So frequency, output voltage, gain, gain in dB. So like that you have to perform experiment number 2, frequency response of a JFET, and which will come nearly equal to like this. So for lower frequencies gain will decrease, for higher frequencies gain will decrease, for the middle frequencies gain will be the maximum one. So this kind of a frequency response you will get when you perform this experiment. You have to plot the graph on a Semilog graph paper.